Hello, everybody. HowlGamer2000 here. Welcome back for more Plants vs. Zombies. Looks like we got a new plant right there, and I'm curious what it could be, because it could be any random plant. So, I guess we'll find out when it gets some food. Also, today I also watched videos, new videos, the reveal of the Nintendo Switch, which I thought was interesting. And, just gonna have to say, man, I liked the Mario Odyssey probably the most. I know I'm a Mario fan, as you can tell by my video content, but I literally think it's also probably one of the good games on there, because I think there's like Switch 1-2, like 1-2 Switch, and I was kind of like, eh, not that one, because it's like, I don't think that not that many people liked it, and I think it's kind of too simple game where you just do a shoot off, and that's it. And yeah, that's all I can remember. So yeah, I just watched it today. I thought it actually, for some reason, I thought it would be announced today, but I actually got it tomorrow. I did notice it late at night, and it looks like interesting. Unfortunately, it's a mushroom because we need that for something else. Oh, also, if you stay around here long enough, these guys will give you money over time. But I'm not going to waste that much time. But anyways, I'm going to see you guys for the shop. If there's anything. If they're not, I'll just cut to minigames. Alright. Alrighty, okay, guys, we're gonna do bobsled bananas. Hello everybody, HowlGamer2000 here. I ran into a problem actually. As you see, this is actually full screen because it's not, I can make my video full screen, but the reason why only this part is full screen is because this isn't my own video, and I'll tell you why. So the story is that I recorded this whole video, like all four levels, because I do four levels each video, so the four levels I did in the video, I did them all, completed, but it didn't really record for some reason, and my theory is because it ran out of, my computer ran out of data during, as it was recording, so it didn't really register the footage that it got. So I didn't want to redo the whole, all four levels, because they can get pretty tedious. Even though I think I can do it again, but I just don't want to go over the frustration and time again. So this is somebody else's video, but I just want to give a shout out to the footage, to the guy's footage I'm using, Kazan Knights on YouTube. This video is actually, I scanned through it and it's been pretty decent quality video. It's in 720p, but this video will be formatted in 180p, 60 frames per second, because my videos are a true HD 60 frames per second, except this one, because this video was like a few years old before 60 frames per second was a thing on YouTube, so that's why. I guess I can't explain how I beat the level, because today, it's the day after I fast-forwarded that part. So I actually struggled with this yesterday, which is Friday the 13th yesterday. Now it's the 14th. So what I did is pretty much I put flowers like that. I kind of did what he did with the flowers. I put those spiky guys as a waiting. But only difference I did was I put cat. Okay, so I put cattails in the middle right there. So yes. Also, it didn't. I also in the same recording I bought cattails. So you'll already see me that I bought it. A cattail, because those are my favorite plants and they're pretty useful. So I use those in the middle somewhere, and then I use those repeaters as well, and I use the jalapeno. And that's like the main important setup that I used. So that's pretty much mostly what I did for my plan. So yeah, I use cattails in the middle, should be helpful too. So yeah, I did go for a slightly different strategy as this guy. So yeah, in each minigame I'll explain how I did it. Sorry, I just had a sip of water. It's not water, it's soda, pretty much. And yes, I used jalapenos for those guys as well. I actually beat it the first try today, but yesterday it took me... I died like three or two times, but actually, the truth is, I actually beat each minigame for the first try. This one today, yesterday I messed up on this like a few times, but today, the level after this, I did for the first try, and the level, two levels after this, I did a first try, and three levels after this, I did a first try, so... Yeah, I did pretty well for what as I thought it would do. So yeah, I'm pretty proud of that. Yeah, the cattails could do pretty good damage. They're pretty helpful. I cannot say that enough. I'm pretty confident in their ability. So yeah. Also, I want to say that. Those Grumpy Squash can also kind of act like those spiky guys when you get rid of those tracker guys with the N on it, because they both do basically kind of the same thing for the tracker guys, kill them in one hit. So yeah, also takes a lot of damage to kill them off too. That's the problem. That's why you need to kind of kill them right out the way, because you need some breathing room from those blood zombies. So yeah, I want to be away from them. I don't think they also showed up in my adventure mode, so that's one thing that probably didn't show up. Also, there is a lot of flags for bobsled room, but if you play this the right way, then you should be good if you plan it well enough. Looks like that guy's plan got squashed, which is okay, because he can just replace it if you can. Also, I didn't use the, I don't think I used those fire trees. I'm pretty sure I didn't use them, as I remember. But I think I used them for a different level. But I will explain how I beat the level. And like I said, I'm not going to go through it all again and stuff. Also, like all the money I got, which won't be shown, but I do have more money now. So you also notice that difference too, and I might have got a present. I don't remember if I did or not. I'll guess I might as well do my last mini games video, record that today, right after this video, because I might as well, you know. So, and then mini games is over, then I just have puzzle mode and survival mode, and I'm done with the series. I also want to talk about the Plants vs. Zombies 2, which first came out on for only iPhone and tablets, I think. I don't really know, because I don't really have a good enough phone to play it with, because I have a pretty cheap phone. I have a really good phone. But the point is that I actually got Plants vs. Zombies 2, It's All About Time, on my computer, downloading BlueStacks. Oh shit. When I clicked on Movie Maker, kind of hit it, it freeze, so I can't really see what else. I can't really watch the gameplay as it goes, which is kind of a problem. Wonder if I can fix that. I don't know. Probably can't, but oh well. So, I guess I can just stop recording and make another. I can restart the narration recording on Movie Maker. Just because when you exit out, then it just pauses the video as it's recording over it. I don't hear the music, by the way. But when I downloaded Plants vs. Zombies 2, I had to play it on Google Play and download it there and everything. It took a lot of time to figure it out. So I can play. I played through the first level. I was like, I think I'm just gonna stop right now, because when I recorded it, because I want to record it this Halloween. The only problem is when I started to record it, it was lagging like hell. So I was like concerned. So I was like kind of disappointed, because I think I'm just gonna have to wait until I get a good phone and screen record my phone, which might be more than a year. So that's another problem that I kind of ran into. But oh well. Have everything that you want. So that was that story. Also want to talk about something else too. I want to talk about the Nintendo Switch, yeah. So that came up recently. Video's probably not going to go up around that time. Video might only come up. Actually, this video is actually going to come up today. I just realized it's the same day I'm recording this. Most likely, anyway. It's right now January 14th, so maybe it'll be uploaded on that day. It's 7:31 p.m. right now. But yeah. Hopefully I'll get the Nintendo Switch around my birthday time. I know it'll be out March 3rd, but my birthday isn't until August 19th, so, and hopefully it'll have, like, they'll take some percentage off the price by the time it's my birthday, after like 5 months. But maybe not. If not, then oh well. But hopefully I'll get it for my birthday. If I don't, then maybe I can help. Maybe somebody can help me buy it for like half the price, a third of the price, or whatever. Because it's $299.99, which is basically $300. So yeah, hopefully I'll get that by then. But if not, then I can just wait until Christmas. And if never, then I'll just buy it myself and use up all my money, because I actually have quite a bit of money that I saved up. But probably the thing I'm looking forward to the most is Super Mario Odyssey, if I even pronounce Odyssey right, because I never seen that word before. And I looked it up as a Greek word. It's epic adventure, kind of to describe it. An epic adventure or something like that. Which is an interesting name. And I'm really looking forward to it, because it's like a new 3D Mario game, which is pretty cool. Looking forward to that. And I can, like, wow, Mario's in New York City at first. I've never been in New York, but my dad has once. It was a vacation trip, like, back in 2009. But yeah, it looks pretty interesting. Climb buildings, can jump off those buildings. It's crazy to me. Like, it doesn't look quite like a Mario game. As I saw like a comment at first, I was like, it is a Mario game, but usually Mario game doesn't play like that. Like a Spider-Man game where you're up in the city, and it's pretty cool. And you can like go fly to the desert on some UFO looking thing. Ooh. Recent Windows Defender summary. No threats. Okay, no threats were found. Yeah, because I had to scan through my computer. I did have like a virus thing, and it happened while I was sleeping yesterday, but I got deleted them.
but I have to pay to like automatically delete them, but I can just search the location that it tells me to go through and delete them. So, no problem. Except when it says I can't delete them, I just have to restart my computer and then it lets me delete them. But anyways, yeah, Mario Odyssey, looking forward to the most, because obviously I'm a Mario fan. If you look at all my content on my YouTube channel, I'm mostly a Mario, big Mario fan. Pretty big Mario fan. I will admit, it's pretty obvious if you look at my content. Also, the only thing is Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, I wish it was Mario Kart 9 instead, but Deluxe is like, pretty much buying the same game, but DLC version. And I already bought the game and the DLC and Mario Kart 8 original. I just don't want to pay through it all again, but I probably will anyway, because I'll be recording those both probably in the future. So it's like, oh well. But you know, at least we get a new Mario game at least. But I can see why they probably did that, because probably because they're like, you know, kind of rushed it maybe for the NX. But another problem about the Masuma RDC, it's not going to be out until the holidays of this year, which is almost a year away. It's 11 months though, pretty much, but it's still almost about a year away. And it's kind of a long wait, but oh well. At least I can play the older Mario games before that, because there's still some Mario games I haven't played yet. Still some Mario games I need to buy that I haven't bought yet. I did get Paper Mario Color Splash recently. It delivered today, I think, but I'm not home today, so I won't be playing it probably until I get back if I'm not busy. So that's a thing. And Color Splash looks a lot better than Sticker Star, because I quit Sticker Star for like 3 years because I wasn't really into it. Then I was like, 3 years later, I was like, I should just beat the game and get over with, because I like to complete games. I didn't go 100%, but I did as much as I could, because I usually 100% games better Mario. Anyway, also, Breath of the Wild looks pretty cool. Not as much of a Zelda fan as a Mario fan, but Zelda I can actually get into if I played more Zelda. Breath of the Wild looks pretty neat for the NX. Or Nintendo Switch. Well, keep getting mixed up with NX and Nintendo Switch, because NX is the code name before the name was revealed. But yeah, I didn't really watch the whole presentation, just kind of scanned through it, because it's like an hour long. But I kind of get the idea of the Nintendo Switch anyway. So yeah, a lot of that information went through my head just a couple days before. I actually didn't really get to see it until the day after it came out. I saw it yesterday, Friday the 13th. Because on the 12th, I thought it would be on the 13th, but on the 12th, I didn't notice it until the 12th at night. But I was like, I'm just gonna watch it, that stuff tomorrow. Just because I was busy that night, really working up late on my science project, because it's been pretty project heavy lately in school for me, because I'm a high schooler now. But yeah, so I'm looking forward to those two games the most. Those Mario games, because I'm a Mario fan. But if I was into Zelda, then it would be 3. But I only have like a few Zelda games, only a few. But I did think about getting more Zelda games, but I think I'm just gonna wait, because I'm collecting Mario games. I almost have I have like over 100 Mario games so far, so I'm almost completed with all that collection. Still gotta buy some Mario spin-offs that I don't have, but you know, at least that'll give me some time to buy those before Super Mario Odyssey. And I also looked at the cost for the controllers. And, they're pricey. They're like $80. I'm like, wow. And I remember when they were like $40, now they're 80. Come on. You know. Oh well. Oh well, I guess. Also, what else should I talk about? Well, I have... Because usually when I play the game, I have a hard time talking about what I want to talk about. Because I have to concentrate on the game. Because I was struggling in minigame mode anyway, as it is. So, yeah. Anything else I want to explain? I talked about the Nintendo Switch, almost an NX, again. So, kind of trying to get used to it. Yeah, I was excited about some part, obviously. I know that. Probably the most out of anything. Oh, yeah, and the 1-2 Switch is kind of silly to me. It's just kind of funny. It's kind of silly. It's a little game where you do a shoot-off, pretty much, with the controllers. And it's like, didn't really show up very well. So that was kind of embarrassing looking. But yeah, just want to mention those highlights that I've seen. Oh yeah, I also saw the Parent Bowl controls with Bowser and Bowser Jr. It was kind of funny. The only problem is can't really mention that to my dad and his girlfriend because I don't want them to be using that for me. Even though I'm like almost 17, they would probably still do something like that even if I'm only a young adult / late teenager around that age. So yeah. But at least the animation was interesting, better than being born. It's probably gonna not be good for the children. I'm glad I'm not children, or child. That's like around 10 or 12 years old. Glad I'm not around that age anymore, so I don't have to deal with that parental controls. But I don't think they've used parental controls that much when I was younger. But yeah, anyway. I should probably stop the narration and restart in a second, just so I know where I'm at in the video, so I'm gonna do that really quick. Alright, now I know where I'm at in the video. Okay, so I can actually explain how I played through this minigame. So pretty much I put the repeaters in the back, and then I put those tall nuts in the second to last column, and then I put magnet mushrooms to the third right behind the walnuts, and put coffee beans over them so they can wake up, and then I put those cattails, of course, in the water, and then I put those fire tree guys in front of, like, around two layers of the repeaters, and that was pretty much my setup. And then, like, as a replacement, when the tall nuts were about to get bad, I just put like pumpkins over them. So that's kind of what my strategy was. It worked pretty well, actually. It was pretty chill for me. Didn't really take that much. It wasn't really that stressful if you have a good setup anyway. Kind of just got to space out and talk about what I wanted to back when I did this too. So it's pretty cool. Oh man. Also, in the last couple days, my right eye was really red lately because of staying up late. I think I did talk about that. And there he goes. He beat it. He beat it very well. I will have to give him prompts for that. Alright, so kinda just cuts to the next video, because that's how he did it, which is a quick way of doing it instead of showing the menu screen of mini games, which is what I do. Alright, so I can talk about my strategy here. So at first I kinda just whacked the zombies normally and all that. I also got rid of the closest graves to the zombies as well, And then, like, later in the minigame, it got kind of fast. So what I did was I just kept tapping my computer's touchscreen, so I kept tapping the zombies, and it worked really, really, really well. It was like, it went too perfectly well when I used my touchscreen computer tapping on the zombies instead of using a mouse, because it would take forever to go to the zombie. So that worked pretty damn well. So that was my strategy. I never used the potato mine, actually. But I actually used the frozen mushroom guy, like, on the last wave of zombies, and that's how. That was pretty much my whole strategy. There was a time where I kind of had to avoid stun one time because there was, like, too much to put on at once. Then that's when I started the shift to touchscreen, because I just realized that. So, yeah. It was pretty nice, pretty nice. So that's why these minigames actually went pretty smoothly. Gonna get a sip of my soda. Ah, man. That's some good stuff. Busy. It's funny how that grape says expired. Kind of can see him doing the same strategy almost. So yeah, now when I restarted this voice recording, now I can kind of see, now I can see the video playing now. Because when I clicked off the movie maker, it just paused somewhere in the video. So now I can see what you guys are seeing, so that's nice, I guess. Looks like it's over halfway done. So yeah, this minigame can be kind of easy. It's already 7:46. Also, I want to mention that I got a new movie today. Bought it on Blu-ray for Blu-ray. I bought Ice Age Colossal Course. Because when I was little, I really liked Ice Age, the movies. So I might as well get the new one. Because I used to watch them over and over when I was a younger person. Like, I think the last time I watched it over and over and over again when I was like 12, I think. Which is like, let's say like 4 years ago. 4 to 5 years ago. Since I turned a different age during the summertime. But yeah, I don't really do that anymore. I don't really watch movies over and over again because I don't have the time anymore like I used to when I was little. Or not really little, but you know what I mean. Still not that big back then, but whatever. Yep, can kind of see a strategy here. For the final wave, I kind of just used the plant, the frozen plant, mushroom thing. And there he did. He did it pretty well. Give him props for that. Alright, so last level, actually. Here it comes up. Zombie. Okay, this one is the fast-paced one, which I did pretty well on, actually, too. So I'll explain what I did here. Okay. Ooh. So, also, by the way, I haven't watched the movie yet, but also, it let me download the original Ice Age movie and the newest one on my iTunes or Google Play or whatever on YouTube digitally, which was interesting. So anyways, my setup here was I put the plants. I obviously put the sun in the back. And then I put, I think I put a, I don't really remember 100%. I kind of just played how I played Plants vs. Zombies originally. Because I think I put like only one layer of sun. Then I put pea shooters. And then I put like walnuts in the back. Then I put cattail in the middle. It's kind of what pretty much only I remember putting. Unless I used a repeater instead of pea shooter. I don't remember which one I used. But I guess you can kind of remember. Let's see if I can remember.
Yeah, I think I just kind of use that kind of setup. I'm not really sure. Don't remember every little detail, but
whatever. So anyways, this video is almost over already. That was kind of fast. So yeah, it's kind of odd that this the format is a little bit different quality than my actual video, my own videos. But you know, that grubby squash actually looked behind him, which doesn't really do in mini game mode for some reason when I play. Really don't know why. I didn't use any pulse or anything. Catapults of plants. But I did use pea shooters, especially, probably. Alright. So there is. Oh, yeah, also, when I started playing this level, I actually talked fast, like, right now I'm gonna play some Plants for Zombies. I'm gonna put plants right here. I'm gonna put a sun right here. I'm gonna put a pea shooter right here. I'm gonna put sunflower. Yeah, I was talking pretty fast when I played this, but I can't. Don't really have the rhythm to do it right now because I don't hear the music right now. But I will say that it was the right pace for me because I like it. Since I have like not as much patience as I used to, it was like the right level of quickness for me because the level, like, everything's faster. Like, you get sun faster, the zombies are faster, the loading's faster for plant cards to do. It was nice, but except that sun fades faster probably, and the money fades faster. I guess that's probably one problem. So yeah, can't wait to get back to my actual gameplay after this video, hopefully, if it doesn't corrupt my stuff. Hopefully it doesn't. This is not water. This is. Whoa. I heard a sound. Also, yeah, I also put tall nuts. And around that column, around the sixth column around there, so the dolphin zombies, and I think forgot those track zombies were the long stick we're called, but I use tall nuts so they don't like jump over any other plants. And look, it's almost over. And yes, this video kind of just ends right off the bat, right when it gets the trophy, pretty much. So, I could just say bye right now, but I'm just gonna wait until he beats this level. So yeah, I beat it all this, like, first try. Don't want to do it again, though. Just because it'll take probably even more time. So yeah, I think he's about done actually. I can see the video is almost over, so that's how I can tell it's almost over. So I guess I can just start saying bye right now. So, yep, this has been HowlGamer2000. I'll actually see you for my actual gameplay, hopefully, and see you guys next time. Peace.